Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Tony Conigliaro Memorial Gymnasium, home of St. Mary's basketball, host now to the Spartan Classic, where there are a ton of teams here playing. This being Saturday, it'll go through Tuesday. Lynn English just lost a very tough game. They were way behind and came back against an outstanding Springfield Cathedral team and got nipped by four. This is Lynn Classville taking on Lincoln Sudbury. They had an easy layup, but they chose to take a dribble and miss the shot. One with the basketball is Almani Medina. Shot got tipped and knocked out. Two is Tyler Wilson, 11 is Jaden Gonzalez, 12 is Nathan Reyes, 24 is Kasharan Sandhu. Too strong with the shot, saved by Lincoln Sudbury. Stepping back, Kyle O'Connell got shut off, pushed to the corner, just turned and threw in a three. Tyler Wilson around the rim and out. Glasgow trying to get a little closer to 500. They're 8-10 as the shot is no good. Lincoln Sudbury trying to go over 500. They're 9-9. Gonzalez looked like he missed it. Looked like it rolled out, but it rolled back in. He gets Glasgow on the board. He's their leading scorer. They go with the fast break. Ryan Lutz out in front of everybody gets the layup. 5-2, Lincoln. Gonzalez has it knocked away. Kyle O'Connor is a big presence inside. He's got to be at least 6'5". Long three, off the rim, no good. Off the rim with the three and getting knocked to the floor was Cordell Bogus. Josiah Sevilla in the game for Glasgow. Marvin Avery, the head coach, he does this a lot. He substitutes quite freely. Too strong with the shot. Off the rim shot. Heads up by Larry Foy. He was on the floor, going to get tied up. He called a timeout. So Lincoln Sudbury will hold on to the basketball. This is, we've got, this being Saturday, six games today, six games Sunday, six games Monday, six games Tuesday. So 24 games being played in 4 days just prior to the state tournament. So a lot of work for the athletic director, Jeff Newhall, head coach of the girls. But he's got good help. They do a great job. And it's a big 4 days for the St. Mary's Spartans. Shoot, Teams will play today. They'll take a day off. Picked off by nicely by Tyler Wilson. Medina really doing a lot of dribbling, just holding on the ball, running the clock out. Gonzalez finally gets it from him, and it gets tipped away and taken away. A little too much shake and bake. Too much fiddling and diddling for Glasgow with people open. They just gave the ball away. Steps called. Nick Rossi caught it. Nice head and shoulder fake, but he moved both feet before he put the ball on the floor. Matthew Carrillo win the game for Glasgow. Slow start for both teams. 5-2. We're just about at the halfway mark. Gonzalez with a fall away. He's got all four. Tough shot, tough follow. Follow again, we told you he's a big boy. He took a very tough shot originally. Tapped his own rebound and was able to tap the rebound again. Finally got it to go. Looking for a three-point play. And he's got it. He's got six of Lincoln Sudbury's eight. It's 8-4. Gonzalez, again, Glasgow dribbling the basketball, trying to go one-on-one. They turn the ball over. The arrow favors them, so they get the ball back, but getting the inbound pass was Nathan Reyes, and he got hit as he took the shot. Two at the line, just past the halfway mark. Slow start for both teams. Missed the first. Made one, and it's 8-5. Off the rim, no good. They'll let it go out of bounds. Medina back in for Glasgow. Off the rim again. They're waiting for the rebound to hit the rim a second time. Lincoln Sudbury comes away with it. Inside, a little too strong. Loose ball. Gonzalez comes away with it. A running left-handed hook. Reyes on the floor, it gets loose. It winds up with Medina. Glasgow got a break there. Off the rim with the shot, no good, tipped up. They lost it going to the basket. And Glasgow wants a timeout. Marvin Avery not happy with what he's seeing. Low scoring, 8-5, 2:24 left in the first period. O'Connell has 6, Lincoln Poe has 8, Jaden Gonzalez has 4 of the 5 for Classical. Robin Avery's been around for a while, longtime coach at Tech. Took a rest for a while. Back here for the first time in his first year at Lynn Classical. We had English, we got Classical, the next game coming up, the nightcap to end the first day of the Spartan Classic will be St. Mary's. And they'll be taking on Lowell Catholic. Full court pressure, looks like a 1-3-1, full court trap. They go up court to Reyes to beat it. Gonzalez took that one from out in the parking lot. That should be worth about 6. And we're tied at 8. He didn't hesitate with that. He just threw it up. High in the air. Reyes for the rebound. Classical can get their first lead. They're going into the weave, trying to get inside. Shot clock winding down. They wind up losing the ball. Off the rim, no good. O'Connell with the rebound. Underhand scoop goes. They almost threw it away. Gonzalez saved it. A wild runner. And it goes out off Reyes. A wild shot by Gonzalez. Under a minute left. 10-8. No, not a whole lot of scoring. Another wild shot tipped around. They'll give it to Medina to bring up. Underhand layup goes. We're tied at 10, shot clock is off. Tough shot again. O'Connell, I don't think he's seen a shot he doesn't like. I don't know what year he's in because they didn't give freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. He's a big boy. This is the first. 18 seconds left, so Classical can take the last shot if they choose. Makes one. Medina again dribbling. Finally gets it to Reyes. From dead in the corner, off the rim, no good. At the buzzer, off the rim, almost made the shot. Corey Garvin almost threw that in. So we were tied at 8, we were tied at 10. The free throw by O'Connell breaks the deadlock. And Lincoln Sudbury takes a 1-point lead, 11-10 into the second period. Lincoln Sudbury will have the basketball. and a one-point lead as we start the second period. Gonzalez, Wilson, Reyes, Medina, and Sevier out there for Clasco. There's a discussion going on over at the scorer's table. Something about, I don't know if this is scoring, teams are going to the sideline. They're officially exchanged scorebooks over there. I don't know if there was an error in the book, or they bring the books together, or. They're sending the teams to the prospective benches. Now they're coming back out. As Clasco comes out, Lincoln Sudbury goes to their bench, so back and forth. There was some kind of problem at the scoring table, but they straightened it out. So Lincoln Sudbury will get the basketball, and we'll start the second 8 minutes. Off the rim, no good. Medina came away with the loose ball. All the way to the basket. He missed it. It got tipped back. Again, it bounced a couple of times off the rim. A break for Lincoln Sudbury. Underhand layup for Nick Rossi. Thirteen to ten, Lincoln Sudbury. Off the rim, no good. Reyes is going to get called for a push off. He rebounded it, but he was able to get the rebound because he cleared house. That's his second foul. Early moments of the second period here, Clasco and Lincoln Sudbury. That's a tough shot. I don't think he had much of a chance of making that shot, but he's going to get a chance to make two free throws because he got hit. No, he's not. They called it the foul on Gonzalez, but they called it a non-shooting foul. Carrillo was covering. He made the pass and he threw it right into the hands of Clasco. Gonzalez took a wacky shot. He was in for a layup. Instead, he tried to over the hand, over the head, lefty. Great fake, but couldn't get the shot to go. Severe. I don't know what Gonzalez was thinking of with that layup. I don't know whether he thought it was going to get blocked. Carrillo's going to get called for the foul. Clasco's in a little bit of foul trouble. They only have one foul to waste with 6 minutes left before Lincoln Sudbury shoots. Up and good by O'Connell. Tipped and knocked out. Medina will walk it up. Thank you. Making Sudbury in that zone. Also trying to find an open spot. It got tipped away. And it got tipped and knocked out by Claskell. So they get the ball back with a 5-point lead here in the second period. Off the rim, no good. They rebound Lincoln Sudbury. 3-point shot by O'Connell. He's got 14 of their 18 points. They got Gonzalez caught in the corner. And they fouled him. Only the second team foul. Again, he tries to dribble through the crowd and they turn it over. Sevilla got it back. They were lucky to get the ball back. They moved the shot clock back to 30 seconds. They had it. Lincoln Sudbury had possession. Sevilla took it back. They were lucky to get it back. And they're lucky to get that one back. And a backcourt violation. They turn it over again. The guys are trying to do a little too much by themselves, not getting anybody else involved. And they've turned it over. One 6 foot five guy goes out, another 6 foot five guy comes in. Evan Lutz comes in for O'Connell. They try to go inside, they throw it away. Strong drive, too strong. Haskell having a tough time. We're halfway through this second period. They haven't scored yet. 3-point basket by Bogus. And we got another timeout. All of a sudden, it's 21-10. It was a 1-point game at the end of one period. A 10-0 run. Pushes that 1-point lead to 11, 21-10. Just about at the halfway mark, Glasgow hasn't scored. They've turned the ball over several times. And they've turned it over without getting a shot. A few times. The winner of this game will get the winner of St. Mary's and Lowell Catholic. We already know that English will get a second try at Beverly. They just played. Haskell almost gave it away again. They block it, but they call a kick. O'Connell kicked it. Haskell having a lot of trouble with this press. They get the ball in, and they're doubled up right away, and they're trying to make a pass that they can't make. Uh, Those are almost, they're very lucky. We have to make those passes. Gonzalez throws in a three. Their first basket took them almost 4.5 minutes. And O'Connell gets it right back. 6'5", and he goes out, shoots threes. The reach-in foul. Clasco finally gets a basket, and O'Connell gets it right back. He's got, O'Connell is beating Clasco by himself, 17-13. And again, a lot of dribbling, not a lot of passing. Three-point basket by Reyes. Gets the lead back to 8. Wild shot. Loose ball, Reyes. Actually banged it off the backboard, but. Shot no good. Blocked by O'Connell inside. That's a big defensive play. Shot no good. Nice shot by Tyler Wilson going over the top for the rebound. Around the rim and out. Inside, they count the basket. Reyes got stuck against Lutz. That's the third foul on Reyes. I don't know if they know it yet. They're leaving him in. So this will be a conventional three and get the lead back to 11. Missed the free throw. It's loose. Reyes comes away with it. Gonzalez will bring it up. Wilson wasn't looking for the pass, and they turn it over. Gonzalez will pick up the foul. They turn it over again. They get inside for the layup. Gonzalez picks up his second foul. And Lutz is back at the free throw line for 2. If he makes this, he'll give Lincoln Subway their biggest lead. He does, and it's a 12-point lead, 28-16. Carrillo brings it up. They get away from that press that time. Tyler Wilson winds up with the ball outside. Strong drive, couldn't get the ball to go. Off the rim, hung, dropped out. Tipped up a second time. Lutz with it. A little over the head hook shot. That height paying off. And the lead balloons to 14. Another tough shot by Clasco. And the undercut, Carrillo's gonna pick up the foul with the break. Corey Garvin. We'll get 2. Clasco just not getting everybody involved. They blocked it. That'll be a jump ball. Lincoln Sudbury, we got the ball. Let's get inside. And they had to block the shot, or he would have had a layup. Lincoln Sudbury gets it back, so everything going Lincoln Sudbury's way. Air ball picked off by Tyler Wilson. Medina trying to go in. Lutz got a piece of him. Thomas Walsh comes in the game for the first time for Classical. Medina blocked, trying to go against that 6'5". A little too strong with the layup. Underhand layup from about 4 feet away, put a little too much English on, spun off, but Classical knocked it out. Somehow they get the pass off. Somehow they get the shot off. I don't know how. In traffic. They have to get it up. They get the rebound, and it gets thrown in by Rossi. Everything going Lincoln Sudbury's way. They're leading by 17. Shot clock is off. And we got an offensive foul against Classical. They set up an illegal screen. They set the screen up, but then they moved. And that's the third foul on Carrillo. Ten seconds left, the shot clock is off. Classical's gonna wind up with 16 points in this first half. Off the backboard, no good. So we were tied at 8, tied at 10. It was a 1-point game at the end of the first period. Lincoln Sudbury went on a 10-0 run to get it up to 11. They kept going, they built it up to where it is now. 17-point lead, it's 33 for Lincoln Sudbury, 16 for Classical at halftime. We're back at the Conigliaro Gymnasium for the start of the second half. Classical over the basketball, but they got a mountain to climb. They're down 17 points. Wilson, Medina, Reyes, Sevilla, and Carrillo are the five out there. Shot, no good. Knocked out, good hustle by Medina to catch up. Rossi was down looking for the full court pass. Looking for the easy layup. Three-point basket by Bogus, his second trifecta. And the lead balloons to 20. Up and good by Sevilla. Wide open, he was waving forever. Lutz, and he missed the layup. Great pass by Bogus. And then Lutz just flat out missed the layup. Oscar with a very small team out there. Literally three guys. Carrillo again trying to go to the basket by three people. He'll pick up a foul. He turned the ball over. Klaskel does that a lot. They tried to hand it inside. They couldn't. Medina forced to pull it back out. Inside, nice pass. Tyler Wilson gets on the scoreboard. Missed the layup again. Haskell on the fly. Gonzalez gets knocked down. Tough shot, threw it high off the glass. Couldn't get it to go, but he'll get two at the line. This is the first. Takes one. Gonzalez had 10 to lead Klaskel in that first half. O'Connell had 17. Lutz chipped in with 8. That's their two. Huge players inside. Tipped again. Gonzalez comes away with it. Again, a tough shot. Off the rim, no good. Tipped up to himself. Garvin getting among the trees and was able to tip the rebound to himself, but then they turn it over with a travel. But again, a tough shot by Gonzalez. Again, there are not many trips down court that Klaskel gets everybody involved. And we got a technical foul. I don't know, is that against Gonzalez? I don't know if he thought he got fouled or he said something. The official didn't like it. That's his third foul. They hit him with a tee. O'Connell makes the first. Makes them both. And he'll get the basketball to boot. They settle for that very quick three. And then Gonzalez obviously said something to the official because he hit him with a technical. Shot, no good. Reyes with another rebound. Reyes playing well. And we got a little bit of a trip. Lutz didn't trip him intentionally, but he stuck the foot out, wind up tripping Sevier. Medina outside. Klaskel wants the timeout. Medina just dribbling around out near half court. Klaskel only got 10 points in the first period, but they were within a point, 11 to 10. But then they come out and got two baskets. They were two threes, but they only got 6 points in the second period. Lincoln Sudbury put up 22, built that 1-point lead to 17 at halftime. They got a quick three to get it to 20 here. But Classical has answered with a 5-2 run. But it's still a 17-point lead for Lincoln Sudbury. I mentioned before, the winner of this will get the winner of Low Catholic St. Mary's. The loser will get the loser of Low Catholic St. Mary's. That will be on Monday. The girls take center stage tomorrow. Shot blocked on the way in. Medina, you get in there and you get the trees. O'Connell and Lutz, they're both way over 6 feet. Wrap around way too strong, follow too strong. And Medina pushes it up. Shot, no good. We got a jump ball. It'll be Lincoln Sudbury's basketball. Lincoln Sudbury gets a little smaller as they take O'Connell out. Lutz comes up short. Lead pass. Tyler Wilson lays it in. Just past the halfway mark of this third period. And we got a foul against Classical. And it's five fouls on Carrillo. Well, Carrillo was out. .341 left in this third period. We had a couple of ties in the first period. Oscar was close, down a point. I think somebody won that 10-0 run to start the second period, and they've been out in front by double digits ever since. They got it up to 20. It's now at 15. Tip, but right to Lincoln Sudbury. They try to go inside. Sevier picked it off, but he was falling down and lost it. Had to give it up. Short. Sevier comes away with the rebound. He's also playing well. And here's Medina dribbling again. Wilson with a wild left-handed hook. Going down the lane. Almost broke the backboard with that shot. He'll get two at the line. Good multi-sport athlete at Classical. He's got five of Classical's 8 points here in this third period. Dante Rucker back in the game. Missed the second. 38-24, Lincoln Sudbury. They try to lob it up. It gets tipped by Sevier, picked off by Reyes. Classical can get a little closer. Off the rim, no good. Long rebound to Bogus. Blocked inside nicely by Sevilla. Again, they've run almost 15 seconds off the clock. They haven't moved at all. They just dribble the basketball. Shot is short. They were lucky to complete that pass up court. The runner around the rim and out. Tip no good. Tipped again. Reyes comes away with it. Tough shot. Medina going down the middle of that defense against three blue shirts. He picked up the foul on the drive, not on the shot. O'Connell comes back. Nice drive, missed the layup. Did everything right and came up short. A minute and counting left in the period. O'Connell with another three. He's got four of them. And again, a lot of dribbling going on, and they've taken 15 seconds off the shot clock. Tough shot by Wilson with the lefty. Shot clock is off. Lincoln wants a timeout. 21 ticks left. Seconds left in the third period. Glasgow has 24 points. They got 10 of them in the first, 6 in the second. They have 8 here in the third. They only have 2 players with more than 1 basket. Lincoln will have the basketball. Let's see if they hold for one. Maskell gets it, that's going to do it. Oh, Glasgow. 3 tough periods, averaging 8 points a period for the first 3. They only put up 24 points. Normally, Lincoln Sudbury 41, Glasgow would be in the game, but they're down 17. Lincoln Sudbury 41, St. Mary's 24 with a period left. I mentioned Classical had 8. Lincoln Sudbury had 8 as well, but you can get away with that when you're leading by 17 at halftime and you only give up 8 yourself. So it was 8-8 the third period. 6 of the 8 points were 2 3-point baskets by Lincoln Sudbury. But they held on to that 17-point lead. Another tough drive, another tough shot. Classical gets a break and gets fouled. They're trying to force an awful lot. Again, not getting a whole lot of people involved. Reyes hit a 3-point basket. They haven't given him a shot since. Medina gets his first point since the first period. Strip taken away by Sevilla, and then he throws it away. They go inside, around the rim and out. O'Connell uses that well over 6 foot frame to get the rebound. He got hit, and that's the fourth foul on Reyes. Bounces the first one in. He's got 23. He's almost beaten Classical by himself. Classical's got 26. O'Connell's got 23. Rick at 24. So they match free throws to start the final period. Marvin didn't like what he saw starting out, calls a timeout. So, going out on a limb, the way the score is, Classical will play either Lowell Catholic or St. Mary's in the loser's bracket. Lincoln Sudbury will get the winner of Lowell Catholic St. Mary's. That will be on Monday night. The girls come in tomorrow. The boys finish up. On Monday, the girls finish up on Tuesday. Four teams in this boys-girls Spartan Classic coming in from everywhere. We mentioned Lincoln Sudbury trying to get over that 500 mark. They're 9-9. Classical has been playing pretty good basketball the last week or so. Has to fire it up to beat the shot clock. Tipped up right into the hands of Dante Rucker, who lays it in. They try to throw it up for a dunk, and they couldn't complete the pass. Offensive foul against Gonzalez, that's his fourth. He pushed off trying to get loose for a shot. I think Sudbury handles the press very well. McCall way outside. Normally you like to have your 6'5 guy somewhere near the basket. They go inside to him and he throws it in. They went back door. Sevier, that's the second shot, and he's made both of them. Not a great pass, just right, a basket just dropped it on the floor for somebody and it gets kicked out. Off the rim. Rebound Lincoln Sudbury. Strong to the basket, he knocked it down. Again, that's one of those shots where the coach says, no! And it goes in, they go, nice shot, Kyle O'Connell. Completes the three-point play. He's got 7 points in this fourth period as they turn, Clasco turns it over. He's got 29 for the game. He needs a lot more to match Tyrese Melo Garcia from English, who got 43 against Springfield. To the basket, he knocks it in again. They've got 9 points in the period. He's got all nine, and the lead is 20. Again, Clasco getting one shot at the basket. Halfway through and counting this fourth period. Height has certainly been a difference, but Glasgow has turned the ball over so many times. Off the rim, no good. The loose ball goes to Lincoln Sudbury. Threw up a prayer, but it wasn't answered. He got inside, leaning away, trying to throw in the underhander. Tyler Wilson with a strong drive to the basket. Taken away. Sevier does it nicely, takes it away and scores. I mentioned he's played very well. Rascal's already got more points in this period than they did in the second and third. And we got 3:16 left. Both teams will be shooting free throws the rest of the way. They go deep. They go almost went too deep. They saved it. Looked like it was going to be thrown out of bounds. And now they dribble behind their back against the pressure. And winds up with free throws for Dante Rucker. Missed it. O'Connell with the rebound. I have to smile a little bit. The rule is everybody has to wear a mask. If you don't have a mask on, you got to get a mask. So everybody puts their mask on and they drop it way down under their mouth. It's like around their neck. They might just as well not be wearing a mask. And I have to say that I'm doing the same thing, but I'm isolated, not around everybody, not making contact with everybody. Gonzalez, no good. He had 10 in the first half. He's got 1 point in the second half. And Sudbury wants a timeout. 2:31 left in this one. One more game coming up. It'll be the St. Mary Spartans take on Lowell Catholic to finish off a huge day here. Six games. We'll continue with six on Sunday, six on Monday, finish up with six on Tuesday. And by that time, the pairings for the state tournament should be coming out. .231 left, 50-34, Lincoln Sudbury. So they'll be taking on, they'll stay in the winner's bracket. They'll take on either Lowell Catholic or St. Mary's in the division final. Clasco will play the loser of Lowell Catholic, St. Mary's. And that will mean an early morning awakening for Clasco. They'll play 10:30 Monday morning. Off the rim, no good. Tyler Wilson, they're gonna call an intentional foul. I don't know about that. Wilson was a step. Noel Lepsky reached around to get the ball. He grabbed him. So they're gonna call an intentional foul. That'll give Tyler Wilson two, and then Clasco will get the basketball. It's similar to a technical foul. Wilson was out in front going for the layup. He reached around. Misses the first. Makes one. He's got eight in the second half. Out deep to Medina. They try to go inside. O'Connell picked it off. Good idea, but that's a tough pass to make. Laskell just chasing the basketball with everybody, trying to make something happen. Underhand layup, he got knocked down, taking the shot. And I don't know who it was because they don't have a number 42 in their roster. O'Connor with another rebound. Sudbury just taking the time, shortening the game up, running the clock. Up and good by Ryan Dooley. A minute and counting left. In and out tip from O'Connell to Bogus. And Tyler Wilson just gives the foul. And that'll put Bogus at the line for 1-on-1. I'm not sure why they're even bothering to foul now. Makes the first. Missed it. Glasgow had it in the hands of Rivas, and he stepped out of bounds. Lutz is back in. O'Connell will go to the bench. Knocked out. So O'Connell almost beat Glasgow by himself. Glasgow got 35, O'Connell finishes up with 31. This will be Glasgow's last trip. And that's, again, impossible. Canale, Cohen, Ellison will get two at the line. And that was just impossible shot. Just lowered his head. Didn't even get the ball off. Missed that one. He makes one. Shot clock is off. All they have to do is hold the ball. And that's all they're gonna do, except they threw it away. Nine seconds left. Hospital's not even gonna bother to shoot it, they're gonna hold on to it. So that'll do it. Glasgow was in it in the first period. A free throw by O'Connell broke a 10-10 tie. It was 11-10 Lincoln Sudbury at the end of one period. Glasgow wound up with 6 points in the second period, outscored by 16, and it was all downhill after that. It got up in the 20s. It finally ends up at 19. Glasgow had their best period, the fourth period, they got 12. They wind up with 36 points. That's an average of 9 points a period. You're not gonna win many basketball games with that kind of offense. And they turned it over a ton for Lincoln Sudbury. Kyle O'Connell was the story with his 6'5", 6'6" frame. He scored 31 points. Lutz, the other six over 6 foot, had 8. Bogus had 7. For Glasgow, Rucker had 2, Cohen Ellison had 1, Sevilla had played very well. He had 6. Reyes had a few rebounds, had 4. Gonzalez had 11, 10 of them in the first half. He only got 1 in the second half. 8 points for Wilson, all in the second half. Medina wound up with 4. And Clasco just couldn't get any rhythm to their offense. They were only getting 1 shot at the basket. The height for Lincoln Sudbury certainly was a difference in the game. Clasco will drop to 8 and 11. Lincoln Sudbury will go over 500 at 10 and 9. Clasco will play the loser of the next game, Lowell Catholic and St. Mary's. Lincoln Sudbury will take on the winner of Lowell Catholic and St. Mary's, and that will be on Monday. So we've got 2 of the 3 games here on Channel 15 in the books. Coming up is St. Mary's and Lowell Catholic, as they will finish off the first day of the Spartan Classic. But Clasco goes down 55-36 to Lincoln Sudbury. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm Don Hoffman saying we'll see you next time.